Hello dear students, in this video we'll study about regulations or regulatory framework of non-banking financial companies. In the last video we have seen about the different types, the meaning and of NBFCs and the different types of non-banking financial company. Now what are the regulatory frameworks or regulations framework of non-banking financial company that we are going to see. In India, the Reserve Bank of India regulates the registration of NBFCs. Though it is not registered with the other sectors as a bank, but even though when it is not called as a bank, non-banking financial company has to be registered with RBI. Reserve Bank of India regulates all kind of non-banking financial companies registration. Similarly, non-banking financial companies do not hold banking license. They don't have any banking license. Like if you go to any other bank, whether a private bank, a cooperative bank, a nationalized bank, a commercial bank, there they will be having a banking license, right? Depending on number of branches, paid of capital, number of customers, what of the type of facilities they are providing, so license is there. But here they are not having any banking license, but they have to follow the rules and regulation laid down by the RBI. Whatever RBI has said the rules and regulation for non-banking financial companies, those all rules and regulation has to be followed properly by all the non-banking financial companies. The company must be registered as a public limited company or a private limited company. The company which you are going to start as a non-banking financial company, either it has to be registered as public limited company or it has to be registered as a private limited company. You cannot start a non-banking financial company as an individual one, like a sole trader or a partnership firm. No, it cannot be started. It has to be registered as a company, right? You require a help of a company here, or you require a registration of a company by the registrar. The companies must have a minimum net owned fund of 2 crores, right? When you start a non-banking financial company, the minimum net owned fund, right, own investment, own capital should be minimum 2 crores. NBFC can offer interest rate not higher than the ceiling rate prescribed by the RBI from time to time, right? Now the interest rate what they are going to charge, it should not be higher than the prescribed rate of the RBI. The RBI will fix a limit that beyond this limit interest rate should not be charged. So that limit has to be maintained even by the non-banking financial companies. The ceiling rate should not be crossed. Repayment of deposit by the NBFC is not guaranteed by RBI, right? As when they are going to register as non-banking financial company, now repayment of the deposits, right, repayment of deposits by NBFC is not guaranteed by RBI. It is not guaranteed that RBI is going to repay you deposits. No, it is not guaranteed. All NBFCs are not entitled to accept public deposits. Only those NBFCs holding a valid certificate of registration with authorization of accept public deposit can accept hold public deposits. There are many NBFCs we have seen in the last video. So all of them, they cannot accept the public deposits. Only those NBFCs who have a proper certificate of registration with authorization to accept the public deposits, only those company can accept the deposits. These companies are allowed to accept public renew deposits for a minimum period a month of 12 max, for a minimum period of total number of trade of 12, maximum trade up to 60 months, right? So these companies, they are allowed to accept the public renewal deposits for a minimum period of 12 months. Up to 12 months minimum they have to maintain it, and the maximum period they can maintain as a public deposit with them is 60 months. Beyond that they cannot maintain. NBFC cannot offer gifts, incentives or any other additional benefit to the depositors, right? Like other banks, commercial banks, they may give you gifts or they may give you incentives, but here these all NBFCs are not allowed to give any gifts, any incentives for in additional benefit to their depositors or their clients. The NBFCs are allowed to accept renew public deposit for a minimum period of 12 months and a maximum period of 60 months. Similarly, NBFC cannot offer interest rate higher than the ceiling rate of RBI. NBFC cannot give gifts. And last point, the deposit with the NBFCs are not insured. Right? When you keep a deposit with any bank, generally a bank will have a insurance. Right? If somebody will steal the money in the bank, right? Some crime will happen, some money is being stolen by some thieves. In that case, the bank generally will have an insurance, right? When the bank will claim that insurance, the amount will be refunded by the insurance companies, and you may get your amount. But in NBFCs, generally they don't have any insurance. So if something happens, then you will lose all your money. Repayment of deposit by NBFC is not guaranteed by RBI, right? See, if NBFC doesn't repay money to depositors, any depositor has kept a money by thinking that they are giving you more rate of interest. Now, if they don't repay you money, it is not guaranteed by RBI. RBI will not take any responsibility in that case, right? RBI will not guarantee that they are going to pay you 100%. But if any bank is not repaying, in that case, RBI has to take a guarantee. NBFC having asset size of rupees 500 crores and above but not accepting public deposits are required to submit quarterly return on important financial parameters of the company. Yes, the NBFCs whose asset size is 500 crores and more, but if they are not accepting any deposits from the general public, they have to submit a quarterly report, right, about the financial parameters of the company. Similarly, the NBFC is required to furnish the information in respect of any change in the composition of its board of directors, address of the company and its directors and names and official designation of its principal office and the name and office address of its auditors. So if there is any change regarding the name of directors, the qualification of the directors, the designation of the people who are involved in the company, right, name and address of the office, different aspects related to the management and management related things, if any change or alteration is there, the NBFC has to do that required furnishing information.